Hello and welcome. I am Tuhin Mukherjee, an assistant professor of mechanical engineering at Iowa State University. With my colleagues from Pennsylvania State University, Dr. Mingze Gao, Professor Todd Palmer, and Professor Tarasankar DebRoy, we just published a paper on keyhole mode wobble laser beam welding in the Journal of Manufacturing Processes. Keyhole mode wobble laser welding involves the oscillation of a laser beam often rapidly traversing along circular paths with a high frequency while moving along a linear welding track. This welding process improves gap bridgeability and weldability, refines microstructures, achieves superior mechanical properties, promotes the formation of equiaxed grains, and minimizes porosity and cracking. This paper discusses modeling, experiments, and the creation of process maps for the wobble welding process. The link to access this paper is provided in the description of this video. During wobble welding, the laser beam wobbles or oscillates along a circular trajectory. The circular movement of the beam distributes the laser energy over a large area, affects the fusion zone geometry, and improves gap bridgeability. Many welding parameters such as wobble amplitude, frequency, laser power, scanning speed, laser beam radius, and the thermophysical properties of the alloy affect the power distribution patterns, fusion zone geometry, and the temperature field. The oscillation of the laser beam can alter the energy distribution, leading to significant variations in the temperature fields and fusion zone shape and size. For example, please consider the spatiotemporal variation in laser energy density on the top surface of the workpiece. The values of the power density are cumulatively added as the laser beam travels along the circular wobble path. The circular movement of the laser beam distributes the laser energy over an area, resulting in significant spatial variations in the power density. In addition, the power density at a given location on the workpiece varies with time during welding. These spatiotemporal variations are the cause behind the evolution of a wide variety of fusion zone geometry during wobble laser welding. To understand the effects of process variables on spatiotemporal variations in energy density and fusion zone geometry, we developed a three-dimensional model of heat and fluid flow during keyhole mode wobble laser welding by extending keyhole welding models developed and rigorously tested at Penn State over an extended time. At first, the geometry of the keyhole was computed by performing a heat balance as well as pressure balance on a point-by-point basis on the keyhole wall. For example, the local angle of the keyhole wall was determined by the balance between three heat fluxes: heat through the keyhole wall, the locally absorbed laser energy, and heat loss due to evaporation. The computed keyhole geometry was then used to calculate the temperature and velocity fields in 3D. Following the computation of the keyhole's geometry, the resulting profile was transferred to a domain suitable for analyzing heat transfer and fluid flow. The conservation equations of momentum, mass, and energy was solved to calculate the 3D temperature and velocity distributions. The governing equations were discretized in a 3D Cartesian coordinate using the control volume method, where the computational domain was divided into small rectangular control volumes. The boundary condition for the momentum conservation equation was determined by the Marangoni effect. The model outputs 3D temperature and velocity fields. For example, please see the 3D temperature and velocity distributions when the laser beam is positioned at the half length of the track during the keyhole mode laser wobble welding of a Inconel 740H. In the figures, the region surrounded by the solidus isotherm, 1563K, of a Inconel 740H indicates the molten pool. The red region bound by the boiling point isotherm is the keyhole. Isotherms are compressed near the front of the molten pool, while they are elongated near the trailing edge due to the welding speed along the length direction. The flow velocity of the liquid material is represented by black vectors. At the center of the molten pool, where a keyhole forms because of the accumulation of high energy, the molten pool shows a deep finger-like penetration depth. In contrast, the molten pool is relatively wider and shallower near the trailing edge. The wobble movement of the laser beam results in a power density distribution significantly different from the Gaussian distribution with a relatively lower power density at the center. However, this power density is sufficient to form a deep and narrow keyhole. The figure on the right shows a 3D isometric cut view of the molten pool to reveal the internal features of the molten pool on a longitudinal section along the welding direction. A deep and narrow keyhole bound by the boiling point isotherm can be seen near the front of the molten pool. The figures show the variations in the fusion zone geometry at different laser powers for constant welding speed, wobble amplitude, and wobble frequency. The peak power density is proportional to laser power. The increase in the power density at higher laser powers resulted in larger molten pools with deep keyholes inside. The calculated fusion zone transverse sections at three different laser powers match well with the corresponding experimental results. Both the computed and experimental results indicate the formation of deeper keyholes at higher laser powers. Here we constructed process maps to show how the fusion zone width and depth can be controlled by modifying the wobble welding process parameters. The contour values in the maps represent the fusion zone width and depth in millimeters. The figures show process maps of the fusion zone width and depth, respectively for various laser powers and welding speeds. Both the width and depth of the fusion zone increase at higher laser power and slower welding speed. In this research, we uncovered the effects of wobble welding parameters, laser power, welding speed, amplitude, and frequency, on the laser energy distribution, keyhole formation, and fusion zone geometry during keyhole mode wobble laser welding of a Inconel 740H. We showed that the fusion zone geometry can be effectively controlled by adjusting the power, speed, and wobble amplitude. In particular, the low power density at a high wobble amplitude resulted in a wide and shallow pool. Process maps resulting from this work can be useful on the shop floor for selecting appropriate sets of process parameters without trial and error.